Hi, my name's Matthew Connors, and this is my path. My story really begins, I was 22 years old, and I was on tour with a band. I played guitar in a hardcore metal band, and we were touring the country, and I came back. And my mom had said that the house is sold, we need to find somewhere to go, and you've got 3 days. And my mom moved out, and I lived with the bass player of the band, and didn't really know what I was gonna do. And a few weeks went by, and I had an opportunity to go on tour with a much larger band and get a paying gig as a musician. I was really excited about it, and my mom called me up, and she had said that some financial things had come through and that if I wanted to go to school, she would pay for it, but I had to go that semester. And it was the fork in the road of go be a rock star or go to college. And I decided to go to school. So I left my friends, I quit my band, I moved out of the town I was living in, and was just totally on my own. And I went to a liberal arts media college in Chicago. And through some synchronicities, I had heard about a particular professor named Bill Hayashi, who had very different types of courses, and people had said that they were life-altering. And I just really felt a strong intuition to go and check this out, this guy's classes. And his classes were booked up. They were very difficult to get into. And I remember I went and met him in person at the registration desk, and he talked to me, and after a few minutes he said, you know what, you belong in my class and I'll make a spot for you. And he actually like fudged the rules to get me in. And the first class I took with him was called Philosophy of Love. I took another class with him called Mystical Consciousness, East Meets West. And all I knew was that when this guy walked in the room, he had an energy about him, an aura, and I couldn't identify it or articulate it or put my finger on it, but I just knew whatever this guy had, I wanted some. And as a young American, kind of lost, you know, male, this guy felt like he had purpose, he felt like he had clarity, he had heart, he had compassion, and acceptance, and I just knew that just by spending time with this guy, that energetically and emotionally, like there was a lot of learning that happened just by being with him. So I ended up taking every class that he had. I ended up meeting my future wife in one of his classes, and I went on a spiritual retreat with some yoga programs that he was involved with, and I had a dream. And in the dream, my spiritual name was revealed, and the name was Shushumna. And I had no idea what this word was or what it meant. And after some research, I later found that in yogic psychology, they believe that in addition to the physical matter that we are, that there is a subtle body, and in the subtle body, we have chakras or energy centers, and that there's 72,000 nadis or energy channels in our body, and that the main channel that rises from the base of the spine through the top of the head is called the Shushumna. And it basically translates to channel. And I didn't quite know what it really meant. I just know that my intuition was that the rest of my life was going to be discovering what is the Shushumna Dharma. And Dharma is a word that means purpose or duty. And that, so it's been this unfolding process and of what is Shushumna and what does it mean to be this channel, this conduit. And since then, it's been an amazing journey. We're in different levels. You know, at one point I was a caretaker for plants, and I was a horticulturist, and I was the life giver for these plants. And at some point, you know, then I was a builder of computers and worked in the tech industry for companies like MD Anderson, and so the, you know, through giving people computer access and access to technology, they could perform their work. So I was the channel in that regard. Obviously, being a father is a big part of that. I work for a cancer company, and after the deals are signed and people buy the equipment, I'm the guy that explains to you how you're going to install it, how we're going to train it. Here's what we're going to do. You know, so I'm the channel for people getting what they bought. And now with the gongs, it's sort of this kind of taking it to a whole nother level where it's just really about the raw frequency and finding what is that particular frequency that people need at any given time. And so it's been the path of Shushumna. I've been a musician for a number of years as it's just sort of my own spiritual path. You know, not professionally or anything, but just more for connection for myself and connection with friends. And I'm working for a Swedish company that makes radiation machines for cancer therapy. And in the early summer of 2014, my whole team was fired, and my father passed away on the same day. And it wasn't totally, I mean, it wasn't like I was a wreck, or it wasn't completely, totally devastating, but it definitely brought this sense of we are on this planet for a very finite amount of time. And things that we can take for granted as fixtures in our life can disappear overnight. And so it really led me into a deeper contemplation about why am I here, what am I doing, and what do I want to do with this life and the time that I have. And part of the working through it, I wanted to make music more with my friends, because for me, music is healing. And everybody kind of had their own stuff going on, and you know, the guys I play with all have their own lives and things. And it just became clear that the medicine for me was really going to be, well, what can I do for myself? What can I do to where I'm not dependent on other people? And that was kind of a new thing for me. And so I had this idea that I wanted to be a looper artist and just immerse myself in playing all the different instruments that I have various skill proficiencies with. And I bought a gong as a musical instrument. And the intention was that I would mic the gong, play a phrase on it, and then loop it and kind of have that be a background drone. And then it would be in the same key as one of my hand pans. And so I got the gong. The Saturn gong was the first one that I got, and I kind of hooked it up to my rig, and I played it, and I just had an amazing, profound, transcendental experience. It was like the perfect frequency at that perfect time, and the overtones and the harmonics of that gong, really, everything about it is resolved. Everything about it is resolute. And it kind of gave me this perspective almost like of being on the mountain looking down in the valley, or being in space looking at the earth, really seeing things from a farther perspective. And I realized that that if I could have that kind of experience, that other people could too. And I received sort of this invitation, this beckoning of that I should share it, that I needed to share it, and I wanted to share it. My heart was asking me to share it. And so it was a clarity of purpose emerged that I didn't particularly ask for, but I was receptive at the time to kind of heed the call and listen to it. And so I realized that, re-realized that sound can be very healing, And I knew that there was people playing gongs and singing bowls, and that, you know, theoretically, sound has been a part of every major religion throughout the dawn of time. And I don't know, I just seemed to kind of grok that at a whole nother level. And to kind of have the insight that I would be used as an instrument to that end really filled me with a new sense of purpose, a new sense of enthusiasm. And I just decided that, you know, when I'm old and on my deathbed, I didn't want to have any regrets, and I knew that there was a unique opportunity that was being presented to me, and I didn't want to have any regrets, so I just went all in. And here we are a few years later, and all this has manifested, and ironically, after 6 months, the company that I worked for called me back, and they said, "We're sorry we did that. The people that made those decisions are no longer here. We really need you back. Would you think about coming?" And I said, "Well, I'll contemplate it, you know." And they said, "Well, you can work from home. We'll give you less work. We'll give you more money." And so basically, they gave me 6 months severance pay to mourn my father and discover gongs. And then I came back, and so I still do that line of work to pay the bills, and now this is what I do for a love offering and a service to the community. So
on my path, I have discovered that my purpose is to hold space for people, to listen to their hearts, what they say and don't say, and to be a mirror and help them be honest with themselves and find fulfillment within and without. I feel their feelings and empathically connect to their frequency. And then I artfully play sequences of frequencies with gongs to unlock their next energetic level, acting as a catalyst in raising their personal vibration. If something resonates within us to be true, we should listen to that, feel that, honor that. And by doing this, we become more aligned with our highest selves, with our role on this planet, with our sacred duty, our dharma. Then we can be who we really are, walk our chosen path, and be of service for the upliftment of ourselves and others. I'm Matthew Connors, and this is my path.